What security software do you recommend? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a common question I've gotten honestly for decades. What security software should I use? What antivirus is best? How about a firewall? What about spyware? Should I use one of the all-in-one packages that claim to do everything? Is there anything else I need? So there's a fair amount of churn, and I'll even call it drama, in the security industry. Things change over time. So it's once again time for my periodic update. Not a lot has changed in the last year, but there are some new things to talk about and consider. Windows Security, previously known as Windows Defender, comes pre-installed with Windows. Microsoft does seem to improve it with every release. Windows Security does a fine job of detecting malware without adversely affecting system performance or nagging you for renewals, upgrades, or upsells. It just does its job quietly in the background, exactly what you want from your anti-malware tool. Every so often, Windows Security comes under fire for rating lower in tests than some other security packages. I get pushback, often such angry pushback, that I keep it as my primary recommendation. There are several reasons I continue to keep Windows Security as my primary go-to recommendation. First, no anti-malware tool will stop all malware. It is incredibly important to understand that. Malware can slip through even the highest rated packages. Second, highest rated changes depending on the date, the test, and of course, who's doing the testing. There is no single, clear, and most importantly, consistent winner. Regardless of how the data is presented, the differences among detection rates across the most current anti-malware tools are relatively small compared to other factors. Yeah, that one may be better by a teeny bit, except that that's the one that's going to nag you for upsells all day long. So there are several practical reasons I continue to prefer Windows Security. It's free. It's already installed. There's nothing you need to do. It rarely affects system performance. It keeps itself up to date using Windows Update. And there's no hidden agenda. It's not going to pester you with renewals or upgrades or upsells, especially not to tools you don't need. It's not perfect, but no security tool is. My recommendation stands. Windows Security remains a solid, free security package with minimal impact. It should be appropriate for almost everyone. That being said, I absolutely recognize that Windows Security might not be right for everyone. Again, no single product will be. This is where I run into difficulty making specific recommendations. The landscape keeps changing. More than one tool that was once free has promoted its paid product so heavily that the free version virtually disappeared. People download and install programs thinking they are free only to discover that it's a free trial or a free download, meaning that if you want to keep it past a certain length of time, you're still required to purchase it. Some programs have become as much self-promotion tools as they are security tools, bombarding you with sales pitches and upgrade offers to the point of impeding your computer use. Things keep changing, so if I mention specific tools below, again, caveat emptor, let the buyer beware. I can't honestly predict how these tools will remain recommendation worthy. So, a short list of top recommendations from around the internet, trusted locations that I believe in, include Avast, Bitdefender, ESET, Malwarebytes, and Webroot. And again, note that these aren't necessarily free and that there are plenty of others. I've selected these specifically because they show up fairly consistently in ratings gains over the years. Don't take offense if you believe I've overlooked your favorite, as I know some of you are going to be offended anyway. Now, I do need to reiterate some really important points. Beware of the word free. In most cases, a free trial is just that, a trial of a full-featured product eventually requiring payment. In some cases, the free trial becomes a truly free version after the trial ends. In other cases, they are separate downloads. And in other cases, there is no truly free version at all. Be sure you know what you're getting. Regardless of what you download, you are still likely to face upgrade and upsell offers or even an ongoing subscription. Unless or until you know you want this, decline. Speaking of declining, when installing any of these, always choose custom installation, never the default. The default might include unrelated software you don't need or want. All right, so what else besides security software? Well, besides having security software in place, I do recommend three other essential actions to stay safe: a firewall, your backup, and staying up to date. For home and business use for a firewall, I recommend using a NAT router. In fact, you're probably already doing it. They don't have to be expensive, and they are one of the simplest approaches to keeping your computer safe from network or internet-based threats. If you can trust all of the computers on the local side of the router, there's no need for an additional software firewall besides whatever is already present in Windows. I strongly recommend you back up regularly. I can't stress this enough. Up-to-date backups completely avoid 99% of the disasters I hear about. Tools like Macrium Reflect and Aces To-Do are the ones I currently both use and recommend. Keep your computer, Windows, and all of the applications you run as up-to-date as possible. This happens automatically as long as you don't take steps to disable it. Needless to say, I strongly recommend you not disable those functions. Let Windows Update keep your system up-to-date. Many of the security issues we hear about are because individuals and sadly corporations have not kept their operating systems or applications current with the latest available patches. And of course, my article/video, Internet Safety, 7 Steps to Keeping Your Computer Safe on the Internet, has more tips for keeping your computer safe. Now, as I update this video, we're a couple of months away from Windows 10 end of support. I want to make 2 very specific points. One is you can continue to use Windows 10 safely after the end of support date. See what happens at Windows 10 end of support for more details. And 2, Windows Security will continue to receive security database updates into 2028. See why I don't expect a Windows 10 apocalypse for details on that. And on top of those 2, you might be able to sign up for the ESU, the Extended Security Updates Program, for additional peace of mind. If you're using a third-party package, make sure you check to see what their plans are. But in general, most of them are going to continue to work on Windows 10 for a long time after Microsoft's official end of support date. So there you have it. It's not difficult, and actually, the 4 things I recommend by default, you're probably, or hopefully, doing already. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/3517. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.